The excitation of seismic waves using hammer strikes is a simple method of exploring what is underground. Shown here on the x-axis is the distance from the source and plotted on the y-axis is the time after the hammer strike. The further away the seismometer or geophone is from the source of vibrations, the later the seismic wave arrives. This means that the velocity of the wave is constant. However, after a certain point, one often observes waves that arrive earlier than expected, and the line of the measurement values exhibits a kink such as here. The wave appears to have become faster. Hello and welcome. In this video, I will be showing you what effects a change in propagation velocities has on the travel path of seismic waves in the Earth and why they have a bent shape. I will explain the concepts of seismic slowness and of the ray parameter and show you what these two physical quantities can be used for. Let's return to the example of hammer strikes. What path do the seismic waves take underground? In the travel time diagram, we see a kink in the curve. The explanation for this comes from the calculation of the seismic path in a model, which consists of two layers with the seismic propagation velocities V1 and V2. In nature, there is often a faster seismic layer below a slower one at the surface. V2 is greater than V1. The description of the travel path is analogous to optical waves, as Snell's law also applies to seismic waves. For reflected waves, the angle of incidence equals the angle of reflection. For refracted waves, the following applies: sine alpha 1 divided by V1 equals sine alpha 2 divided by V2. If the wave has an incident angle such that alpha 2 equals 90 degrees, the wave, or head wave, travels along the boundary between the two media at the higher velocity V2. Sine alpha 1 divided by V1 then equals 1 divided by V2. In this case, the angle alpha 1 is called the critical angle alpha c. Sine alpha c is then equal to V1 divided by V2. The measurement instruments placed at the surface will then register the waves reflected back up to the surface. You have seen that at a boundary surface, the angle of the refracted wave changes along with the seismic velocity. The relationship of sine alpha divided by V, however, remains constant. This value is called the ray parameter and is represented by P. It describes a seismic wave on its path through the Earth and has a unit of time over distance that is seconds per kilometer. Hence, P remains unchanged whether wave is reflected or refracted, or even when P waves are transformed into S waves or S into P waves. The ray parameter characterizes an individual wave and is of great significance in parallel computer-aided calculations of the various ray paths of an earthquake. Ray path can therefore be bent at layer boundaries. Over longer distances, this ultimately leads to bent rays. In order to illustrate this, you see a comparison of two waves here. The direct wave travels along the uppermost slower layer to the seismometer. The other wave travels through underground layers at a continuously increasing propagation velocity and is gradually deflected along a curved path until the ray reaches the critical angle and moves horizontally as a head wave. The rising wave then travels back to the Earth's surface at the same angles it followed on the way down. In this case, the refracted wave arrives at the seismometer before the direct one, because, despite the longer path traveled, the velocities underground were high enough to result in a shorter travel time than for the direct wave. For a wave traveling horizontally, such as the head wave we just saw, alpha equals 90 degrees, making P equal to 1 divided by V. For a wave traveling vertically, alpha equals 0 degrees and hence P equals 0. In general, we can illustrate P graphically using this figure. At right angles to the wave propagation is the wavefront. P is therefore the horizontal component of the vector. The vertical component is denoted by eta and equals cosine alpha divided by V. Together, P and eta form what we call the slowness vector S. We see that it is equal to the reciprocal of the propagation velocity. P is therefore the horizontal slowness and eta the vertical slowness. However, the name slowness is not quite consistent from a physics standpoint, because both slow and fast describe velocities and not their reciprocals. Despite this, the name has established itself because slow media exhibit a high slowness and fast media a low slowness. Imagine how the wavefront and the figure would make its way back up. It would strike the Earth's surface at exactly 1 divided by p. Hence, the ray parameter is the reciprocal apparent velocity at the surface. And because p is constant, this applies regardless of the angle of emergence, actual propagation velocity, and wave type. So far, we have only spoken about even layers. If we wish to apply these concepts to the spherical Earth, the distance r to the observed point to the center of the Earth also needs to be considered. In the figure, we can see an earthquake ray with a distance r1 to the center of the Earth, which is refracted at a layer boundary with a distance r2. According to Snell's law, sine alpha divided by v1 equals sine alpha prime divided by v2. Let me expand this with r1. In the large triangle, the following applies. Sine alpha prime equals the path on divided by r1. In the small triangle, the following applies. Sine beta equals on divided by r2. On is therefore equal to r1 sine alpha prime, which equals r2 sine beta. If I substitute this in the first equation, we get r1 sine alpha divided by v1 equals r2 sine beta divided by v2. Or in general, for the spherical ray parameter, p spherical equals r sine alpha divided by v. The unit of p in the spherical Earth is therefore one of time, or rather time per radian, such as second per degree. However, the constancy of p over the entire path does not change at all. At the vertex of a ray, the angle beta equals 90 degrees and the sine is therefore 1. Here we define the following: r equals rp and v equals vp. The ratio between radius and velocity at the vertex can now easily be determined with measurements of the propagation velocity on the Earth's surface, the angle of emergence of the ray alpha 0 and the Earth's radius r0. This relationship is called Bendorf's relationship. In this video, you learned that the ray parameter p characterizes a wave and remains constant along the ray path through the Earth. Regardless of whether it is refracted or reflected, the ray parameter does not change. The ray parameter is also called the horizontal slowness and equals the reciprocal apparent velocity of a wavefront on the surface. Together with the vertical slowness eta, p constitutes the slowness vector, which is at right angles to the wavefront. Both parameters are useful for all applications in seismology based on the ray concept, and simplify calculations with straight or bent rays in the Earth that are triggered by an earthquake or a hammer strike.